So hello guys, welcome to my channel, Liz Tamwon. If you are actually new, please, I'll just urge you to subscribe to my channel and be part of my family. The family is actually growing and I'm so thankful for everyone that has subscribed to my channel. We are actually on 600, which this is actually unbelievable. I actually never knew that I'll be like having 600 subscribers at this moment. Today, I actually want to encourage someone out there to say, you are in that situation for a purpose. You are not in that situation just for a mere reason. God has placed you in whatsoever you are actually going through. You might think to yourself to say, God, this is actually too hard. Why am I not moving forward? Why am I stagnant on one place? Why am I only the person encouraging other people and yet nothing is actually happening in my life? Why is it that I'm barren, I'm not having children? You have kept me so long for me to conceive. Why is it that, God, you are not letting me get that job? Why is it that, God, I know you have a lot of things to tell your God and to remind him, but let me just tell you, I want to encourage you with this word, which is coming from the book of Esther. And this word, it actually blessed me in the night when I was actually going through it. I was like, oh my God, I need to share this word. I need to just tell someone out there to say, you are in that situation for a purpose, because God was actually revealing a lot of things to me, was just trying to communicate with me as I was actually reading this Bible verse. Because many other times people will talk about certain kind of things upon your life to say, look, you are poor, look, you are not having a baby, look, you are sick, look, there's this and this and that. But they do not know why God has actually allowed you to be in that situation. Like, for example, I love to give examples for myself. Like, for example, I would just say, God was telling me to say, Liz, look how your life has been in the past, whereby you could care for other people's children. Now you have your own children and you don't have anyone that is actually helping you out. And yet people, they might not understand that I actually allowed you to work as a maid. I actually allowed you to help other people's children. I allowed you to do this and that because I was actually preparing you for a time like this. Because if you had not gone through that preparation, you wouldn't have managed to care for your own children. Now that God has blessed me with a big family, I just want to say, God, I'm so thankful. Today I can be called a strong woman, but it's not like I'm a strong woman. It is because God has actually prepared me for this journey. He actually made me go through certain things that I could see them to be, oh, this is so tough. It wasn't too tough for me, but God was actually preparing me for a time like this. So I want to just remind you where you are. I don't know where you might be watching me from. I want to tell you to say that sickness that is actually in your body, it's not like God wants to break you. He doesn't want to break you. He wants you to know that even other people, when God heals you, other people who will be looking up to their healing, they will actually tap into your healing. They will actually look up to you and say, wow, if God can do this thing, that means he can actually do it for me as well. It's not everyone that is supposed to be rich in this world. Let me just tell you this. You should know that the most important thing for you to call yourself rich is to have the Lord and as your personal savior. You accept Christ. You have him in you. That is the greatest richness that you can ever have, because richness is not the money that we see. It's not about this God that we see. These are just the riches of the world. But the richness is above in heaven. When you die, you have to ask yourself to say, where am I going to spend my eternity, God? If I die today, you can ask yourself that question to say, if I die today, God, where am I going to spend my eternity? Is it going to be in hell or is it in heaven? This is why we have to work extra hard each and every day towards our salvation. We have to work so hard because we do not know when we are going to die. It's only God himself who knows. But I want to remind you to say,
Every situation that you are in, there is a purpose. God cannot place you in that situation without a purpose. Look at the story of Queen Esther. Queen Esther was actually put in that palace. Not that God wanted to make her to be famous, to be like rich, to be this and this. No, because Esther was put in that palace for a purpose, and this is what I want to read for you so that you can understand why God actually placed her in that palace. It was for a purpose. So let me just read this. So this is Esther chapter 4. When Mordecai heard about the letter, he tore his clothes in sorrow and put on sackcloth. Then he covered his head with ashes and went through the city crying and weeping. Then verse 2, it says, but he could go only as far as the palace gate, because no one wearing sackcloth was allowed inside the palace. 3, in every province where the king's orders were read, the Jews cried and mourned, and they went without eating. Many of them went even put on sackcloth and sat in ashes. For it reads, when Esther's servant girl and her other servant told her what Mordecai was doing, she became very upset and sent Mordecai some clothes to wear in place of the sackcloth. But he refused to take them. Esther had a servant named Hatach, who had been given to her by the king. So she called him in the and said, find out what's wrong with the Mordecai. Why is acting this way? Hatach went to Mordecai in the city square in front of the palace gate, and Mordecai told him everything that had happened. He also told him how much money Hannah had promised to Haman had promised to add to the king's treasury if the Jews were killed. You should understand this. This was the time that was very hard for the Jews, because they were actually fighting a battle. This was actually a battle. To us, we might just look at it very simple, but it was a very big battle, that it was only God who can actually intervene into this battle. So here in verse 9, it says, Hatach went back to Esther and told her what Mordecai had said. She answered, tell Mordecai, there is a law about going to see the king, and all his officials and his people know about this law. Anyone who goes in to see the king without being invited to him will be put to death. The only way that anyone can be saved is for the king to hold out the gold scepter to that person. And it's been 30 days since he has asked for me. Then Mordecai was told what Esther had said. He sent back this reply, don't think that you will escape being killed with the rest of the Jews just because you live in the king's palace. You have to understand this verse 13. It is actually a very strong word, and this is the purpose, because this one, Mordecai was actually reminding Esther, because Esther was also a Jew. So he was actually reminding her to say, look, you are not in that place just for you to enjoy alone. You have to understand that God has put you to be the queen for a purpose like this, because this time around that we are having this difficulty thing, it would only take you, Esther, to actually speak for us Jews and present us whatsoever matter that needs to be addressed, and you will actually have to do it. So in 14, if you don't speak up now, we will somehow get help, but you and your family will be killed. It could be that you were made queen for a time like this. Esther sent a message to Mordecai saying, bring together all the Jews in Susa and tell them to go without eating for my sake. Don't eat or drink for 3 days and nights. My 7 girls and I will do the same. You see what God can do. So this is actually a powerful way that you can actually meditate on, and it will actually build you in every situation that you might be going through. Because many other times I ask myself to say, God, why did you bring me in this land of Germany? And I don't have the answers, but most of the time I find a lot of answers, because God had brought me in this land not for me to enjoy alone, but he has actually made it possible for other people. It's not everyone that I'll meet will get a blessing from me, but there will be a certain connection that God will actually make in order for something good to happen. So this is one thing that we need to understand, to say every place that you are in, you might be, God might have lifted you as a family, like one of the family members who has just made it in life, and you think as if, wow, since now I'm doing so good, I'll forget about everyone else. Yes, you might forget about everyone else, but you should know that there is something that God has placed you in that place for, because he knows that not until that thing is fulfilled, that is when his purpose will be said, it is done. But if it is not done, there will be someone who will come to you, not for money, but there will be someone who will come to you either for encouragement, either for prayers, either for healing, anything that it is supposed to be done. And I'm telling you the truth, you have to understand that that thing that you are going through now, God is preparing you for something great ahead. And you will say, oh, Liz, you don't understand. I've been here for 10 years looking for a man and the man is not even coming. You should just wait and understand to say God's time is the best, because God knows to say, even when he allows you to go through those disappointments, he has got something good that you will actually appreciate and recognize God, to say, God, you are worthy. God, there is none like you. God, look at how much you love me. You have given me this thing that I treasure so much. You will even forget about all the disappointments that you actually had. It's the same way when for the woman, I don't know, maybe you are going through miscarriages. I also went through miscarriages, and that moment, I know the pain, how it feels when you actually get to have a miscarriage. You feel like breaking, you feel like the world is coming to an end. But let me just tell you to say, it is not the last stop that God is actually stopping from your house to say, okay, this is now, you are going to just stop here, you're not gonna have that baby. God is letting you go through that because he knows that other women will go through such a thing, who will need an encouragement from you who has actually gone through that situation. He knows to say that if I don't allow this thing to happen like this, this person won't serve a purpose. So if your purpose is actually in encouraging people, if your purpose is actually in helping children and other things, he will actually let you go through those things so that he mends you, he actually make you stronger. Even when some other things come, they won't break you, because you are already made by God. God has actually put you in that place so that you can serve that purpose that he wants you to actually do. So please, I beg you, don't look down on yourself to say, God, look, I'm the only one here, all my friends are having this and this and this. Oh my God, let me just tell you to say, if you look at the story of Haman was actually a very good army commander. He was rich. But do you know what happened when he was actually sick of leprosy? Who actually helped him to get the healing? It was actually Elisha. He was actually told to say, you have to go in the in River Jordan and dip yourself. And he looked back to say, why am I told to go and dip myself in this River Jordan when there are good swimming pools in my country where I am coming from? But it was because God was supposed to fulfill that purpose. It was supposed to be done according to his will, not to the will of Naaman. So this is why I'm just telling you to say, whatsoever God allows you to go through that fire, just go through it. Allow him to touch you, to go through that process, so that when something happens, I'm telling you, you will actually glorify the name of God. You will know to say God is God. Now you may not know to say God is God because those situations that are breaking you, they are making you feel like crying, they are making you feel like nothing is actually working in your life. Let me just remind remind you to say, please look up to God and keep on touching his garment, to say, God, I'm not going anywhere, not until you give me something that belongs to me. Shaye, in Bemba, that's how we say, Shaye pakamumpale mwene sawande. You are not going anywhere, God, not until you just change my situation. That is what God is calling us for. We have to actually see him to say he is the Almighty God. It is only him that can actually save us. It is only him that can change certain situation in our lives. So please, I'm begging you, don't look down to yourself. Just touch the garment of God and believe that God is mighty. He is the great healer. He is the situation changer. He can turn blood to water. He can change